A massive project is underway to construct an energy superhighway connecting three states. Hundreds of kilometres of transmission lines will be constructed, promising to build a more reliable power grid, secure Australia's clean energy future, and ultimately bring down bills.
In a dusty back corner of New South Wales, critical work is underway to transform the nation's energy future. Transgrid is building hundreds of kilometres of transmission lines that will connect New South Wales, South Australia and Victoria.
It will move renewable energy into the cities. It will also move energy between the states, making our system more secure, lowering cost.
And it's an impressive task. To construct the transmission towers, workers climb more than 40 metres above the ground. A five-tonne piece is carefully winched up and lowered over the top of them.
The crane has to be absolutely spot on.
It is almost like threading a needle.
The wind is picking up, but millimetre by millimetre, the structure is edged into place like a giant steel meccano set.
Obviously, this steel gets very hot very quickly, and up there in high winds and high temperatures.
This is Australia's biggest transmission project, and the sheer scale is mind-blowing. 1,500 of these towers will be constructed, eventually connecting 900 kilometres of wires across three states.
Extending from Baronga in New South Wales to Wagga Wagga, Robertson Town in South Australia and Redcliffs in Victoria, also linking to other new projects in the pipeline, all harnessing power from renewable energy zones. This will prove crucial in the next decade as five power plants retire, which today account for 13% of the East Coast's electricity capacity.
To get energy from where it will be produced in the future, out in the regions with renewable energy, wind and solar, into the cities.
Transgrid says it will cut household bills by $64 a year in New South Wales once it's up and running, hopefully by the end of next year. But it won't come soon enough for this winter, when it's predicted we'll be paying at least 20% more for power.
Coal is closing, renewables need to be built. If we don't get our skates on and get there in good time, we're going to find that we'll struggle.
For now, it's one tower at a time on a long road to clean and affordable energy. In Baronga, Annalise Bolt, Nine News.